ill-considered and unprecedented. That's how 13 former senior national security officials describe the president's decision to revoke John Brennan's security clearance. In a letter, they defend the former CIA director's character and called the president's allegations of wrongdoing, quote, baseless. For more on this sharp rebuke, let's bring in former CIA spokesman Bill Harlow. He is the co-author of the book Hard Measures, How Aggressive CIA Actions After 9/11 Saved American Lives. Bill, thanks very much for taking the time.
Thank you.
First of all, I understand you have some news that some more names are going to be added to this letter.
That's true. The letter that went out yesterday was done in a very short period of time, and it was sent out to the CIA directors, deputy directors, and DNIs, and not all of them got back in a timely fashion, but just this morning we've heard back from two more, Admiral Denny Blair, one of the former DNIs, and Vice Admiral Bert Callen, who was a deputy CIA director a number of years ago, who have asked to add their names to the list. So there are now 15 former senior officials signing on to the letter that was released late last night.
We should note that these officials on this list, they served both and were appointed by both Democratic and Republican presidents. You served under both Democratic and Republican presidents during long service in the CIA. The president likes to dismiss these folks, well, certainly John Brennan, as partisans. You've worked under and with these men and women for some time. Is that an accurate appraisal?
Not at all. When I worked at the CIA for 7 years, the senior level of the CIA, I couldn't have told you what any of the people there, what their personal politics was all about. Mm-hmm. Now, this is not about a person, this is about policy. You can disagree with what John Brennan has to say, or you can disagree with the way he says it, but he has a right to say what he wants to say now that he's not in government. The U.S. government has a thick manual that gives examples of how you can lift somebody's security clearances. There are reasons why you can take away somebody's security clearance. None of those reasons are saying something that the president doesn't like. Now, some people have said, well, that this letter implies that we think that the president was trying to stifle John Brennan, mm-hmm. and I don't think that personally. I think the stifling is on other people in government, other people in former government officials who see what's happening to John Brennan and might dial back what they're saying mm-hmm. in order to not risk offending the president. Now, nobody wants to offend the president, but when you're no longer in government, you have a right to give your opinion. Mm-hmm. If it's an opinion which doesn't stand up, then let the White House respond to that from the lectern at the briefing room, but not by taking away their clearances.
Are you concerned that beyond an attempt to stifle free speech, that this is also about undermining the credibility of the Russia investigation? Because, well, you heard the president just there again make that charge, but several of the folks on this list, John Brennan, he was head of the CIA at the time that the assessment was done that Russia interfered in the election. And remember, part of that assessment was that it was to hurt Hillary Clinton and help Donald Trump, an issue the president has never been particularly fond of. James Clapper was the director of national intelligence. He's on that list. James Comey, of course, was the director of the FBI at the time. He's been fired. He's on that list. Are you concerned that this is part of the president's intention here?
I suspect it probably is. I think there's not a single reason why they did what they did. That's certainly part of the reason. It helps them undermine the credibility in their mind of the investigation. It was also to change the subject. It came right after the difficult press briefing about Omarosa and the N-word tapes. Yep. It's on the eve of potentially results of court proceedings in Alexandria. So throw up this dust and see if you can confuse the situation a little bit. I think there are a lot of reasons for doing this, none of them good.
One reason that former officials keep their security clearances is to be consulted if there are issues of national security where their experience might be relevant and valuable. You speak of a guy like McRaven, who stood Admiral McRaven, man who was commanding Special Operations Forces during the bin Laden raid. He raised his hand. He said, listen, take mine away. He's been involved in hundreds of raids against terrorists very successfully over time. We did some calculation of the other folks on that list have at least 268 years collectively in national security. Is that experience relevant to a president when the country is facing threats?
Absolutely. You want the people who are currently in those jobs, the top jobs at the CIA, at the DNI, the Pentagon, to be able to go back to some of their predecessor and ask them questions. Mm-hmm. There's a misimpression when people think that senior officials have security clearances that they're going back to their old office and rifling through the files and looking for information. That's not the way it works. their successors invite them in and say, here's a problem I'm facing. Let me brief you on what we're seeing.
Right.
What do you think? They don't have to do that. But by taking away the clearances, they can't do that.
It gives them an option. You're great to clear up that, because that's been a confusion. People think you just have access to walk into the CIA every day. No, but it gives the option if the president says, listen, hey, Admiral McRaven, we've got a terrorist operation that we're considering. We'd love your counsel on this. Come on, we'll brief you.
Have you faced this problem before? How did you deal with it? What do you think about what's facing us? Give us your thoughts. They don't have to follow those thoughts, but if they don't have the clearances, they don't have the option of doing that.
Right. Well, folks at home might want to know, is that the kind of experience that they think will make their country safer? Bill, thanks very much for taking the time.
Thank you.